What's up, everybody? This is Jay, and this video is about the new trailer for Power that released today about who shot Ghost. Now, they have a new kind of format they're going to do for the show, and it's a whodunit kind of format. It's been done on many other shows before. Now it's coming to Power, and they released the trailer kind of talking about it. Now, before we get into it, if you haven't already, please subscribe and hit that bell notification so you're notified of all my videos, and also hit that like button if you enjoy this video and recommend it. Now, when the video comes on for the trailer, it's going from dark to light to dark to light, and we see it's some type of police interrogate room, and then we hear that they are all basically answering questions about who shot Ghost. And you got Tariq, and he's saying, "Who shot my dad? Why won't you tell me if he's okay or not?" So we know that he's been shot, and this is not a dream. But what we don't know is, did he die or not? And so then they got him being asked these questions by J-Lo, Blanca, and we see Tasha. She's saying, "Yeah, I admit it. We and James, we did have problems, but I did not shoot him." And so then they got Dre, he brown nosing. "Hey, why would I try to kill him if I'm supposed to be helping you? I think I'm gonna go and be a civilian until you figure this out." Then they got Dirty Ball Sacks, and he's talking, and he's saying, he's a murdering drug dealer. Okay, it's a lot of people that would want to kill him, and I was this close to putting him behind bars for good. Maybe if I did, none of this would have happened. Wait a minute. I know that sounds like a confession, but I didn't confess. I didn't do it. I don't know who did it. Then they got Tommy. "Hey, I don't know what you think about asking me, but you should know I ain't no snitch. So if you need me to talk, I ain't got nothing to say." And they pretty much got everybody being questioned. They got Paz. "Oh, somebody killed Jamie? They chewed him? Oh, okay. It wasn't me. I wasn't chewed him. If I was going to take him, I would stab him. I would stab him. That's what I would do. But I didn't do it. And that's good. He deserved it for what he did to Angelita. Okay? I don't care about Jamie." Meanwhile, they got Councilman Tate, and he's sitting there being questioned, and he's like, "Hey, look, I'm running for the first black governor of New York. Why would I shoot him?" Meanwhile, he dressed in all black with a hoodie, looking like a, you know, liquor store robber. It don't make sense. And it's also interesting, how did they finally bring all these people in for questioning when they can't never find no other way to bring people in for questioning at no other time? But it seemed they got all these people brought in at the exact same time in the same clothes they was wearing the night of. So that's pretty interesting. Nevertheless, every single one of them being questioned are saying they didn't do it. So it leads me to wonder, are they all just saying that because that's what criminals would do? And Dirty Ballsacks, wouldn't he be in police custody anyway? He was going to jail the next day anyway. So they could be questioning him in an orange jumpsuit instead of questioning him like he a free man. But at the end, they all say, "I didn't shoot James St. Patrick." And then they got some type of America's Most Wanted hotline thrown up on the screen. So I wonder if people actually calling and saying that. I don't know. Now it's time for real talk. I think it's interesting that they're trying to put this whodunit, who shot Ghost thing together, but at the same time trying to leave it as mystery. Did he die? Maybe they're going to wait to the end for us to see if he lived or not. And I don't know. It's just interesting that they're trying to like prolong the season with the suspense build up on everybody watching the last 5 episodes wondering, is he dead or not? But I don't know how they got all these people round up for questioning when they never seem to get people round up for questioning any other time for any other case. Not for Lakeisha murder or anybody else murders that's been going on. But now all of a sudden Ghost is shot and they got everybody the exact same night. That's kind of interesting in the storytelling process. And why is J-Lo the only cop that gets to do this, work this case. She's the one that's working the case. She the one interrogating everybody by herself. I mean, she got to be overworked. It's got to be a hell of a caseload. I mean, I don't understand that. Anyway, I'm Jay, and that's Real Talk right there. Now, if you haven't already, please go to the website, www.jmorereviews, and leave your comments at the Power Fan Forum. A lot of people have kind of stopped going since Power's been off, but now it's coming back. Leave your comments below on the video as well as on the website, and we can all get together and keep this conversation going. And also, check out my Patreon channel. I got a lot of new videos on there. I got my latest stand-up comedy on there as well I've been working on, and I appreciate if you check it out. I want to thank everybody that support me at Patreon, including my two newest members, Damon 4030 and Sean W. Thank you for joining the family. I really appreciate it. And last but not least,
thanks for watching.
Please
leave a
comment,
hit
that like
button,
and
subscribe,
and
I'll see you
in the
next video.